evening. Thank you for tuning in. Tonight's webinar is going to be about the hands-on data processing portion of writing a research paper. I happen to work in a lab where we do this type of stuff, so yeah, I just wanted to share my knowledge, I guess, of this process. So I won't talk too much about it. I guess I can talk a little bit about my setup and the cabinets behind me. So sorry, it's such a weird angle. I'm going to be doing a lot of things with my hands, pinning beads and stuff like that. So yeah, I need some space and this is the best angle for that. And these cabinets behind me, they actually hold drawers of beads. I don't know if you can, yeah, you can see the drawer here. They hold like a bunch of those, so there's a big collection of mostly bees here, some wasps and some flies, but yeah, so I'm going to just grab a bag of bees and start pinning. Okay, so I have a bag of bees here, and some information on it. After the bees are caught in the field, they're put in the vials and put into this bag. A vial. There's like three bees in it, so this will be quick, which is good. And you have to record the information. So this is the binder with like labels and numbers and stuff. to write these numbers down. These are the pins needed to pin the bees. Good job, son. Another number because there's three bees. I'm going to have to cut some. I usually use styrofoam to put the bees on when we pin them. Glue. And hopefully I can do this quite fast. Oh, it's too low. Is on there, and it's a lazy blossom, if that means anything to anyone. After they get pinned, they get put into a white box. And the next step in this process. It's a quite long process, to be honest. Okay. So I think they're all the same genus. This one only has two bees, so I'll do this one as well. Okay. This one has a little bumblebee and a green bee. I'm making enough sounds for this video. It's kind of hard because I do have to concentrate a little bit on what I'm doing. Okay. Let me just record this. 30227 and 30228. Next, they go into a white box that gets a label. Everyone gets a label. And it already has some bees in it, so just add these. Still drying on that last one, so I'm going to wait to put it here. I do have to put a label on this, so I can go ahead and do that. Labeling tape. Okay. it's time to enter data about the bees that I just pinned. And so I'll log on first and then. Also, I moved the sheets into here because I didn't need the clipboard. Okay. Open Excel because we use Microsoft Excel to enter the data. And you just kind of go across and enter. So numbers first, I started with 30223. And I entered until 30228 or I pinned to that. So do that. And then just enter B was, and then the sex of the bee. And the plant that it was collected off of, it's kind of just like a code. It's the first three letters of the genus name and the species name. So this one happens to be Potrick. These bees were caught July 3rd. And the site where they were caught. Who caught them? So, after they're entered like that, I guess I should go in order, we put labels on the bees, so I have a box of bees to label here, and just show you that. All these bees, they were caught in New Jersey for a research university for graduate students' research. So I'm not just out here killing bees or anything.
Trying my best.
Okay. So. Starting with the first bee. It's 28333. You just match it up. 28333. And voila. This step is where they get identified down to the species level. We have microscopes for that because they are needed. Not so much for the bumblebees, but for any tiny, tiny bees, it's necessary. So after they're identified, that's when they get moved into the chores. And after they're in the chores, they're ready to be entered onto the computer. So data entry. photon scanner we have. And yeah, I think I have to kind of register it, so. These bees are males. They're agapostomin virescens. Virescens, I'm not sure exactly, but they're little green guys with striped abdomens. Sorry, I can't focus this camera. Hopefully I can get a better one in the future, or for future videos. So, to enter these, it's quite simple. You just take one out, scan it. Oh. That's interesting. Let's try. This isn't working. Careful with these because they're quite delicate. So you honestly just pick them up one by one and scan them. It's not anything too exciting. And after they're scanned, they need to be entered with their genus and species. Most of the time, when we're pinning, we can misidentify that, so. Yeah. Save that. And so, that really, I should put these away, concludes the process. Was interesting and made sense. If you actually want to see more of like something, because I kind of just breezed through, I'm going to stick around and pin some bees and label some bees. I'm going to try to finish that whole bag. That can take like a really long time, but yeah. So after that, I'm going to label some bees. I'm not going to do much more on the computer, to be honest. Yeah, but I'll be right back. Thanks for sticking around. I have the same bag of bees, and I have quite a few to pin, so what I was thinking is I might change the angle of the camera and get closer to the action. So let's see what I can. Okay, so I've situated myself a little bit better, I think. I make some great sounds because really this is a awesome field for just different sounds. If that makes sense or whatever. Thank you. Hopefully you can see. Oh, no, it's terrible. I don't know if you can. Oh, yeah, these green bees are really cool. I can get some pictures and stuff up on my Instagram, but until I get a better camera, I won't be able to get close, unfortunately. So sorry if this grosses some people out. I don't know how the general population feels about pinning insects. Well, I guess I'm not sorry, but sorry for your loss of interest. Because it's a shame. It's cool. I love identifying them. What I usually do, but I figured this would make a better video. This one has really long antenna. He's cute. I could get close. It sucks. I can get a picture of this one probably though. Okay. I have to glue these little guys. Well, not the green ones. And there's quite a few, so I think I'm going to cut this whole row or thank you. scribbling and stuff isn't very loud. I'm trying to get it. In there with like a lot of bees. But we'll see.
Okay.
So that one's all done. particular bee is actually like my favorite. It's a male Bombus grisiaculus. And I'll be uploading a picture of it after this video onto my Instagram, so check it out if you want. This is a little honeybee. I haven't had any fragile ones. Sometimes they break apart. Thank you. I should also get a drink of water. I forgot my tea at home. Excuse me. Okay, now, so I cut that little sheet of numbers, so I think I'm gonna try to finish it really quick. And then I am going to tackle that large pile. Anyone cares to stick around for that? This would be too long. Okay. Honestly, not that many left. I'm just nervous because, I don't know, there's not that many sounds. There's not much sound variety that comes with labeling, and it's very tedious. Three, four, seven. 3, 5. Usually I would like listen to music while doing this or something. So, I mean, if it's boring to me, then it could be boring to other people, I'm sure. But just let me know, I guess, what you think. I am trying to go pretty fast as well. Alright, so I have a good amount here. I'm gonna finish done with this. I'm gonna put these back while I'm talking, but I am going to pin some more bees and finish that back. And I'm gonna resituate this microphone actually. But stick around if you want to. If not, just skip it. I'm gonna probably say some stuff towards the end about my channel and future videos. So check that out for sure. Okay. Now on to more pinning. And I'm gonna pin these bees, but before that, label this box. So do that.
So many in here. Okay.
genitalia part because it's useful in identification, believe it or not. And yeah, so most of these are females though. There's a little guy in here. Oh yeah, that's another thing. You have to check the legs because bees like to get caught up in these big bumblebee legs. I guess I'll do it. I kind of already know what these are, so I don't really need to. Since there's this little one, it has to be glued. So thank you. Unless my phone's out of room. But I don't know. Sorry about that. I feel like this is a male. But I don't know. It's like a female. Not sure. Okay, so that's done. I just have to put them, I'll record them, put them back in the box. But I guess while I'm doing that, I'll chat a little bit. Oh, wait, there's so many. Oh, I gotta do the numbers as well. Okay. Mm-hmm.